Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to be discussing about self-driving cars. It sounds magical, doesn't it, for a car to drive itself? It was thought to be almost impossible a few years ago, but today it is almost in action. Of course, not on public roads, but fully autonomous cars or self-driving cars are indeed a reality, at least in private roads, in closed campuses, and in experimental driving projects. So, have you ever wondered what goes into making a self-driving car drive itself? Well, today, we shall learn about it. Let's begin. Self-driving car. How does it work? That is the topic. So, there are two paths to a self-driving car. One is intelligent hardware. Various kinds of sensors loaded on a car, installed in a car, and artificial intelligent operating system that is designed to make the driving decisions. So, broadly speaking, there is the intelligent hardware and there's artificial intelligent operating system, what I call as AIOS. When both come together, a car can achieve fully autonomous capability. Well, let's understand more in detail and let's take a step-by-step approach. A little bit of history. DARPA, that is the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, DARPA in the US, started a grand challenge in the year 2004. And that grand challenge encouraged and incentivized research projects across US to participate with their concept and prototype of a fully autonomous vehicle. And 2004 was, of course, the launch year, but every year thereafter, the quality and build and efficiency of autonomous vehicles has consistently improved. Then in 2009, Google launched its famous Google Car project in a garage. And today Google Car has perhaps the highest number of virtual miles in self-driving car projects around the world. And Google Cars also have the largest amount of actual road miles as compared to any other project which has been launched with regards self-driving cars. And in 2015, Tesla launched the autopilot feature, which gives you a real-world experience of an autonomous vehicle. So, that is a short introduction from a historical background of self-driving cars. Now, let's discuss about what is the need for a self-driving car. Well, globally, more than 1.2 to 1.5 million people lose their lives in fatal road accidents, and almost over 92% of these road accidents were because of driver distraction. Distraction caused owing to fatigue, owing to driving under the influence of alcohol and other substances, and owing to a lack of attention, which means all of these accidents, all of them are preventable. Well, self-driving cars aims to overcome the human weakness, which is to lose alertness and to make wrong decisions when the brain is tired. A machine can continuously work and process without getting tired. A fully robotized autonomous vehicle will never be under the influence of alcohol or any other drug. And therefore, there is hope in making sure self-driving cars become a reality that we can achieve Vision Zero, which means zero accidental death on roads. While this is a moonshot idea, projects which have been carried out by OEMs and other companies investing in R&D for autonomous vehicles have achieved considerable amount of success. Laws are being formulated. The latest one has been announced by Germany as recent as last week, allowing a legal position and a framework for a fully autonomous vehicle, and assigning responsibility of who is accountable in the event an autonomous vehicle actually leads to a road accident or loss of human life because of an autonomous vehicle. Companies like Volvo have committed that they would go completely electric, and going completely electric enables a lot of companies to transition into more intelligent platforms, and more intelligent platforms brings them closer to self-driving cars. The Society of Automotive Engineers has provided 5 levels of self-driving or autonomous vehicle. So most cars today are at level 3, which means they are aiding the driver with advanced driver assistance systems and reducing the amount of accidents caused due to human error. Level 3. Level 4 is autopilot, for example, by Tesla, where the car can drive itself, but in the event of an emergency, will need human intervention. And level 5 is hands off, eyes off, brain off of the human operator, which means the human being is no longer responsible for the driving functions of the car, even during an emergency. That is level 5 fully autonomous vehicle, or what we call as self-driving cars. So now that we've established a context, let's get into the actual subsystem level hardware and software integration in order to understand how the self-driving car actually works. So, here's a diagram of a self-driving car. You have in a self-driving car a very powerful onboard computer. This onboard computer does all the processing required by collecting information from all the sensors. There is a very important imaging device called as LiDAR. LiDAR stands for Light Image Detection and Ranging, or in other words, it is nothing but a radar which uses light, laser beams. And as you know, we can use light, we can use sound waves, or we can use radio waves in order to create a sense of the environment. Whereas a LiDAR specifically uses light. And what a LiDAR does is it gives an output called as point cloud, which is nothing but x, y, and z coordinate of a spatial image. The objective of a LiDAR is to be able to see and visualize the space in all three dimensions and create what is called a point cloud map of the real world. And a point cloud map of the real world is extremely powerful and useful because this can be created under any weather conditions, whether it is raining or bright and sunny or snowing or hailstorm or daytime or nighttime. A point cloud can be created by a LiDAR irrespective of external environmental weather conditions. Therefore, there's a LiDAR. And there is a stereo camera. A stereo camera is exactly a representation of our human eyes. We're able to see. And when we see, the process of seeing means we are resolving the image in three dimensions and we are able to recognize the objects within the image. That is seeing. A stereo camera is able to resolve the image. And identifying the images, the objects, the actual objects inside that image after resolving calls for a very advanced image classification and recognition technique, which is a branch of artificial intelligence, and that is called as deep learning within the field of computer vision. Deep learning is also called as convolutional neural network, CNN technique. And the objective here is to recognize the objects within the image. We will deal with image recognition in another session and have an in-depth understanding of how image recognition actually works. For this session, stereo camera is able to resolve images for the self-driving car. And there is a continuous connectivity via the telecommunication unit or TCU, which provides GPS enabled location service. It has a GPS built-in GPS module, and it has telecom connectivity to 4G, 5G telecom towers. And this is important in order for the car to locate itself vis-a-vis the map, vis-a-vis the actual geography where it is currently driving. So, LiDAR, stereo camera, there's a domain controller which communicates with all the electronic communication units, control units within the autonomous vehicle. And there's an onboard computer. So, these are the broadly speaking important subsystems that we must take into consideration in order to understand the working of a self-driving car. So, now that we have established the subsystems, what is the actual process? Well, there are five steps in the process of self-driving. And in order to understand those five steps, let's ask five questions which are relevant. Process of self-driving car. First question, let us ask how a car sees. How is a car able to see its environment? That is called as computer vision. And computer vision is achieved by using a stereo camera. Next, how does a self-driving car sense the environment? So a self-driving car senses the environment by a process called as sensor fusion. So sensor fusion is bringing together data from all the self-driving car sensors, as explained, LiDAR, stereo camera, every other sensor that's available within autonomous vehicle, blind spot detection, forward warning collision, adaptive cruise control, and many more. It brings all the sensory data and processes this sensory data in order to make sense of it, in order to interpret that data into information. That process is called as sensor fusion. Remember, we are dealing with things at a high level because we are in the introductory phase of a self-driving car lesson. Third question to ask is, how does a self-driving car locate itself? And that process is called as localization. And localization is achieved using the connectivity of a self-driving car, using the GPS modem or the TCU, high definition maps, which are provided and loaded onto the onboard computer, and by seeing where the car is currently located, let us call it point A, it can determine itself as X and Y on a particular high definition map, actual coordinate of where it is located. So what is the next step? How does a self-driving car plan a route from A to B? That process is called as path planning. So path planning, once the car has located itself at point A, it needs to now derive and decide on a route to take to reach point B. That is called the path planning process, and it will always optimize against weather conditions, traffic, and any other information that is fed into the localization process by the cloud, computing resources, the high definition mapping resources, as well as the edge analytics carried out by the onboard computer inside the car itself. And finally, how does a self-driving car drive? And that process is called as control or maneuver. So, as you can see, the self-driving car mimics the human driver or the human brain's ability to maneuver in any traffic conditions by seeing what is in the driving range, identifying the various objects within the driving range or the image in which is visible to the driver, then deciding whether to decelerate, accelerate, brake, stop, take a left, take a right, overtake, or slow down. All of the functions of the human driver, which the brain decides in coordination with the bodily functions and organ systems, such as the eye, the finger movement, the leg control, all of that put together. Similarly, these five steps, computer vision, sensor fusion, localization, path planning, and control, embody the process of driving by a self-driving car or a fully autonomous vehicle. So, the core of a self-driving car is computer vision and sensor fusion. We will understand this more deeply as we go into this topic of self-driving cars. Now, before we finish, one thing to reiterate, a point cloud created by a LiDAR is a very interesting 3D map of the world as created by the LiDAR when the car is moving or when the car is stationary. This technology is extremely powerful and is already being used by NASA and by space scientists when objects are sent into outer space and objects are mapped for various space use cases. Similarly, LiDAR has always been used even for other applications apart from automotive. So, watch out for more videos and interesting videos on self-driving car, using artificial intelligence and creating an operating system that works on a self-driving car, and other related topics. If you are enjoying these videos and if you're gaining insights, please do subscribe to my channel, share, like, click the bell icon for notifications, and please do comment so that I can produce content which is more relevant to my audience. Thank you.